Hi guys, today I bring you a different video. Thank you guys for the love and support from the previous video. If you haven't watched, please stop a bit, pause a bit, go back to that video of what I packed for my 5 months for a road trip. Please go check it out and come back right here. I'll still be here. Thank you guys for the support, for the love from the previous video. I feel you. I feel the support. I feel you guys coming in. And for the new subscribers, again, you're welcome to the new family. Thank you for joining us and thank you for being a part of us. And thank you for the support. As always, for my returning supporters, thank you again. You're here for another one. Well, as by the title, I always keep my notes in my phone. This may not be a video for everybody, but I remember when I was going to go through that a week before the doctor told me what I had to go through. I remember I desperately searched for videos like this, people who have been through, and what I could find are videos of either medical practitioners or people live in labor going through that after inducing. I just wanted someone to talk about it post, someone who had gone through it before and it's after some time and they're talking about it. People might think, yeah, you don't remember. I remember as it was yesterday. I remember as it was 2 hours ago. I cannot forget my experience. The video today is inducing, my experience with inducing in labor. And I had a natural birth. I wanted to say not all inducing leads to C-section. No, I had a natural birth. This is my experience. Well, I was 41 weeks overdue. Imagine for your first pregnancy and you're 41 weeks overdue. Can you believe that? Yeah, I was freaked out. I was like, when is it coming out? I had this thing during my pregnancy, my insulin was fluctuating. I could not go over 41 weeks. By all means, she had to come out. The doctor was like, if she doesn't come at this time, we have to induce you. And I'm like, where's the tea? Get ready for the tea. This is the tea on inducing. So yeah, I was like, wait, what? Inducing? What is that? Sip some tea. I went desperately searching for these videos, but I could not. I wanted someone who has been there for me to relax. So I'm here for that video. I was 41 weeks. Obviously, when you're being induced, you're overdue, right? Yeah, I was overdue. I was 41 weeks. Time came. I was scheduled to go to the hospital that day. I was scheduled to start my inducing. I waited. Obviously, I went to the doctor before, a week before, on the 40th day when I was 40 weeks. And then the doctor was like, okay, we give it a week. If she doesn't come, then you have to go through this. I was like, okay. So the day comes, fast forward, and I was 41 weeks. I went in the hospital and I was told you're going to be given this prescription. It doesn't go more than 48 hours, so I was given the prescription first for 24 hours. Now they tested out and then I was supposed to go back in case she doesn't come by then, and then I get the prescription and everything is well. We go back home. I was staying in hospital hotel. I will make a video of this one. It's called Sjukra Hotel, for those who don't know, in Iceland. If you live out of Reykjavik, your doctor or your midwife can apply for you and you stay there. It's just right next to the hospital. If you're sick and you're outside Reykjavik, you can stay there. The prices are very subsidized. Iceland. You are taught. This is a very good arrangement by the government, to be honest with you. It's for subsidized. The services they give, you have meals on time. I couldn't imagine how heavy I was. I was super duper heavy. I was tired. I was exhausted. I couldn't mind being back home and making all these meals. So this hospital, you find meals ready. Breakfast, lunch, dinner, everything with a subsidized price. You can imagine. I stayed there for more than a month because I was having my baby in December, and being December, we have lots of blizzard, snowfalls. I've been heavy. If you haven't, it's heavy, it's windy, the snowfalls. You literally see a few meters when you're driving, just what's in front of you. Never even seeing what's in front of you when you're driving. So you have to prepare and go early. Where you're gonna give birth? I chose to give birth in Reykjavik. You can choose to give birth in other cities. Like I was given options, Akureyri, Ísafjörður, but I chose Reykjavik. I went early and I stayed there for more than a month, and my husband stayed there for 2 weeks. And imagine, of course, he had to work and all that. I go back to that hospital hotel. It's opposite the maternity ward. That's the beauty of it. I get the tablets I was supposed to take every 3 hours. So what I did, I put an alarm every 3 hours. It would allow me to take. My appointment was at 8, so I had my first tablet at 8, and then count 3 hours apart, I was taking those tablets. So what happened is, yeah, I thought I still had time. I kept taking up to 3 hours. It came to around 5. Well, I started to feel strange. I'm like, maybe I'm exhausted. Let me take a nap. I took a nap. Well, waking up, girl, that strange feeling woke me up. I told my husband, I think it's time. He's like, yeah, no. They said it's 48 hours. I'm like, well, let's see how it proceeds. So by then it was coming to 6. Mind you, they had told me 48 hours. This is less than 8 hours. So I'm like, no, I'm still safe. It's not happening. My husband and I were like, nah, it's not happening. Fast forward, it is 6 and now the pain intensifies. It's not a pain. It's a very, you know, before your period, the week before, the bloating and that weird pain. It's not a pain. It's a very uncomfortable feeling. That was, but then maybe times 5 of that feeling. It was a very uncomfortable feeling, I remember. And I was like, this is strange. I have never had this before. What I remember is a period pain, but this is intense. And I'm like, something is happening. Obviously, I was taking the tablets. I knew what to expect, but I didn't expect it that soon. Fast forward, come to almost 6. And now the pain apart, I'm like, this is it. Every time I would ask somebody, how does it feel when you're in labor? And everyone would be like, had to make sure I'm recording. I do not want to be talking to myself and the camera is not running. I would be super duper crazy because I had gone that far. I felt like this is different. That was around 6:30, and then I'm like, okay, I need to use the toilet. I felt a gush. I think I'll give the story for my labor on another day, but yeah, I felt a gush and that was my water broken. I didn't flush. If it's your first time, remember I used to ask everybody, how does it feel? And everybody said, you will know when time comes. To be honest, that is the time I knew. I'm like, hold up, I think I'm in labor. The good thing, normally you know you're quick to flush. It's a reflex after using the toilet, you flush. So for me, I'm lucky. I just got up and so, because it was a huge gush. It's not pee, it's huge gush. I remember I told my husband, this is, I think something dropped. My water should have broken. It's like the sixth sense. You know what's happening. You know your body so well. And you know the strangest things that will happen. So when something is not familiar, you will know. I told my husband, I think my water has broken. Fast forward, yes, it had broken. Earlier that day, I was given a number to call the hospital in case I feel different or I feel a certain kind of pain that I cannot take anymore. Actually, they first told me to call the hospital when my water breaks. And then they'll let me know what to do after, whether to check in or to stay, or just, I think they just want to see how you're feeling, just not panicking. I called the hospital, but the lines were busy. I'm like, I insisted, obviously I was calling, and my husband was on the phone. I could not obviously hold the phone because I'm like, this is it, showtime, we're going in, she's coming now. We got hold of the hospital. How do you feel? Do you feel, is it too much, unbearable, you can't take it anymore? I told him, yeah, I feel the pain and it's so short apart. This is not what I've been, you know, midwife telling me, it's long apart. No, it was very short apart. They're like, okay, you can stay, you can wait a little bit. If you can hold it in, then you can come in. So yeah, I waited, and I remember I waited, it felt like eternity, but I think I must have waited 40 minutes, but it was intensifying. So that's the other thing. Let me say, every woman out there, if they tell you you're going to be induced, do not feel any kind of different or do not panic. It's okay. This comes to my other part that I was going to talk about, inducing. Things happen real quick. They don't give you time to feel, to be in your feelings, to get excited. It's happening right there. She delayed to come. She's coming now. With inducing, the pain is intense. What I was told with labor, obviously I wasn't naturally. My labor didn't start naturally. It was induced. What I was told with natural people who start is gradual. You keep feeling it. The contractions are apart, further apart, and then they come closer. This, inducing, the difference is if it's a scale from 1 to 10, this will start from 5. Yeah, that's the amount you start with. For me, that was my experience. It happened real quick. Remember, I was given 48 hours, maybe 24 hours. Mine started within 8 hours. When you're being induced, just prepare anytime. Because depending on your body, anytime it's coming. Yeah, it was super duper quick. My water broke less than 10 hours of giving me this medication for inducing. And then the contractions were short in between. My husband would be like, okay, there's a breathing technique. This, oh my God, YouTube is like the whole university of life. I remember I went on YouTube way before I started reading about labor, what to do, how to keep calm. And there are these videos about calming yourself and breathing techniques. And I was using those techniques that were really helping me. This is a fact. When you breathe in and out, it actually really does help. It takes away some of your pain. Because the more you stress out, you tell the body, I'm stressed, and the communication doesn't go well. Something like that, too much science, the communication. communication doesn't reach somewhere, but when you breathe, you allow your body to communicate, and then it calms your pain, it calms everything, and all the muscles relax, and it makes you relax and less pain. For my mamas out there, you're expecting, it's your first time, you've been told you're going to be induced, expect it to really happen real quick and the pain. But again, just remember to breathe. Look out on YouTube for these videos. There's so many videos, breathing techniques. People have been there and they're very experienced. They teach you how to relax, how to breathe between your contractions, and this helped me a lot. So I was really breathing, but again, the pain was way. So I went in the hospital and I was checked. It wasn't anywhere. I was just 1 centimeter dilated. I came back to the hospital hotel, but the pain was a lot, and they were so, the contractions will come way close to each other. I remember it was an hour. It was around 8 p.m. I called the hospital. I told them, sorry, but I gotta get in because the pain, I can't take it anymore. The pointers that I wanted to point out, they gave me tablets. It was real quick. It happened real quick. Yeah. It was supposed to be at least 24 hours or in between, but it happened in 10 hours. So you can expect that. And my water broke less than 10 hours as well. And then the contractions, when they happen, they really start to happen. They don't give you time. They are there. They're coming for you. That's the difference. And then the dilation was fast. The first time I checked in the hospital, I was 1 centimeter dilated. Then when I went back to the hospital hotel, I can hang in there, and then I couldn't. It was an hour apart. I couldn't. Well, I remember it was 8 p.m. and I called the hospital. I told them I'm coming in. And then when they checked me, I was already 5 centimeters dilated. Imagine in the span of 1 hour, I was 5 centimeters dilated from the previous check. One thing you should expect is a fast dilation. That is if you really take the pain of the contractions and you don't ask for any kind of medication. But I remember at this time when I got in, I remember, yeah, the pain was way too much. Real quick, I was at 5 centimeters dilated. The pain, girl, the pain was intense. It was a lot of pain in a very short time, and the contractions started happening way fast in close apart. That's what you should expect, the other thing. And then the feeling, as I talked about, this feeling like you know, the feeling before, like period pain, that is the feeling. It's like an intense, more than a period pain the week before, but the bloating and the other uncomfortable feeling, I really did feel that. So my advice to you anyways is to check into the hospital when your water breaks, or just call them up and then ask, what should I do? Because for me, I remember I checked in, I was 1 centimeter dilated. After an hour, I was 5 centimeters. So when you're being induced, it's better you're very close. I had prepared my bag, my baby's bag, my mom's bag. Let me tell you, when that happened, when I had to go to the hospital the second time, I just grabbed a jumper because it was raining that time, put on the hoodie, and then we were out of the door. And then it was the next day when I had a baby and I was looking for diapers. Where's the bag? I was asking my husband, where's the bag? Asking my husband about my bag. He was panicking because I was panicking. But nobody remembered until the next day when my baby had come, and then I was looking for diapers. And of course there were diapers, they gave us diapers, but I needed my own diapers. And I'm like, my bag, we didn't break my bag. That pain will make you. So just be prepared. Just be calm and be prepared. Don't panic. That's the thing. I remember I did not think much. I just up and left, grabbed a jumper. It wasn't even my jumper, it was my husband's jumper. I just grabbed it and left. Whatever you have, probably put next to the door of where you're going. Depending, obviously, if the hospital is close to you, you put the things in your car, you just drive off. And if it's not the case, just put them right by your door. It depends on what situation. For my situation, my hotel was just opposite the hospital, so in this case I just had to put things right in the door so that I remember to at least grab one bag. These are the things you have to expect when you're being induced. I said expect the pain to really be real quick. Things will happen so fast. It's not even about the pain, it's about the water breaking, is about the contractions happening and your dilations. Everything happens real fast. And also, I wanted to say, with inducing, not every inducing ends up in a C-section. I was very lucky. Mine did not end up in a C-section. I had a normal birth, and yeah, I don't know what, if you call it normal. I don't know what's normal, because C-section is also a normal birth. So I don't know. That's it. That's what you have to expect. I remember I searched for a video like this just to know what I'm getting into. There was no clear video to show what exactly. It's just medical practitioners or someone in the labor showing their labor, live labor, in the video. I just wanted someone who had been posted that, that's my baby, I gotta go check her out. Guys, I want to come on here and end this video. I hope this helps you if you're in this position. My baby's right there, so I keep looking and seeing if she's okay. Yeah, so I hope this video helps you and you know what to expect when you're being told you're going to be induced. Everything will be okay. That's all I can tell you. The advantage is it happens real fast. Everything is going almost times two faster. Everybody who's going through this and every mom who's about to have their baby, I wish you nothing but the best of luck with your baby, good health with your baby as well, for you to come out yes, like the strong woman you are with your baby. Anyways, I wanted to wrap up this video, and then I want to say a quick prayer for every woman out there. Lord Heavenly Father, every woman who is expecting, who is going through labor, who is about to go through labor, may you... My baby, she needs my attention. I want to pray for every woman who is going through labor, who is about to go through labor, who is about to have their baby. I pray for them to have the best of health with their baby, for them to come out of the labor ward with all the victory. Lord, I pray you bless them with good health and they bounce back real quick, the mothers out there. And then I pray for the babies to be healthy and no complications whatsoever. In Jesus' name, I pray. Anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video and I hope it helps every mother who is going through labor and everything. I just wish you nothing but the absolute best. You will be fine. If I could make it, you will make it too. You will come out a victor as always. I just wanted to come up here in this video. I hope you liked it. I hope this video helps you. And if you have any questions, just, you know what to do. Put them in the comment section. I'll be answering every question regarding labor and inducing and everything else. And from your mind, as always, thank you guys for the support, for the returning subscribers, for the new subscribers. Thank you again for the support. If you have anything you want to ask me, you know what to do. And then click on the notification bell if you haven't, so that you're notified every time I upload a new video. And if you haven't subscribed, please come on, our family is lead over here. We are lead. Look at my cup, it's live, love, sparkle. We sparkle over here. We love our family and we're living our best lives, right? Yes, right. I just want to say thank you for the support. And if you haven't watched my previous video that I put up about what I pack for my 5 months, please check it out. It could be a good checklist for you so that you don't have hassle. Just have this on your go, you have it on your phone, because I did that work for you. Yes, if it's for you, then I mean, you're welcome. Anyways, from me and mine, as always, bye. Yeah.